it's not all you know, perfect and easier and improved. Maybe we can talk about some of the kind of the downsides, the things that are a little bit more difficult in App Engine, you know, as a result of you know, how it's set up and how it's designed.
The happy path is paved with concrete and it has chains along the side, and so you really can't leave the happy path. So that's something you have to keep in mind. And there are failures from time to time that, you know, a query can work just fine, and then all of a sudden the next time you make exactly the same call, it doesn't work. And those are just, you know, things that you get in a big, eventually consistent, kind of amorphous sort of machine. And so you have to deal with those. And so you start to, you know, a lot of times you kind of want to do a looping sort of query where, you know, you're willing to do the query three times. And, you know, within the three times, you'll probably get the result and the first one might, you know, fail. But you just reperform the same query before you let your request handler send a response back to, or an error response back to the user. And so, which is actually kind of a good pattern because, you know, in distributed computing, you're going to encounter failures. And you need to program defensively for those, you know, like system sort of failures. So being ready to do, an issue or a retry and kind of putting that into your normal, you know, call stack or your framework, I guess, you know, it's easy to do. But it is something that, when you really want your app to start running smoothly, and those are the sorts of things, Udacity is dealing with or learning about now, to do the retries on things like queries. You have to be cognizant of how long a long-running task on a back-end is going to take. Mm-hmm. You get a limit of, I think it's 10 minutes, and which seems like a long time, but on a highly virtualized system, you can actually, have a 10-minute long-running task. So you have to be prepared to shut it off early and then be ready to pick it back up with a subsequent request. One of the other things, I guess, would be a lot of people wanting to, when you get a bigger Python system, you want to have C modules, pre-compiled in. You don't get that. So you kind of forget about those sorts of things. And then the biggest one, which I know that Google is addressing, and they have a beta program, which, I'm very hopeful that it happens soon, is better SSL certificate support, especially for the custom domain. You get SSL on, domain.appspot.com, but if you point a custom domain to it, you don't get SSL support for that, which is a big drawback, and it's something they obviously recognize and they are fixing.
Cool.
So hopefully in time, please Google, that will be there.
So one thing that I was skeptical about coming in is the database and how much access you have to your own data. Are there any kind of, limitations there that need to be thought about?
Definitely. That would something that's probably worthy of a whole unit in a course about going deeper with App Engine. There are a few, I think, things that you kind of have to come to terms with, and they're trade-offs. Every life is trade-offs, right? Especially with scaling a website. And for a lot, you have to put up with things like all queries have a limit of 1,000 records, and that's before paging, which kind of sucks. So you can, if you could potentially pull out, a result set that was 1,000, none of with just empty records, and then you have to page to the next one to get the three that matched. So depending on how it is that the indexing and your collections or your model, I guess, is structured. The backup and restore thing is real awkward. There's some backup and restore utilities built in, but not, if you wanted to just take the data on a nightly basis and sync it to a testing kind of QA sort of, like a prod QA sort of version of your app. And there are some, tools out there that, basically allow you to export the data as Python code, and then you could run it, and import it into another app. But in the back of your head, which is, on the one hand, it's nice to have some transparent costs. We can tell you pretty much exactly how much every one of our queries, costs, which is great. The downside is that when you're doing something like a backup, in the back of your mind, you're going, man, this is costing a lot of money. Yeah. So it's, things you can get around, but not as smoothly as, just taking, in a hot backup of your, you know, the local files on a MySQL database, something like that. The other one is that there's no real great data viewer. You know, there are times when you're troubleshooting, you just, you know, you really don't know what's going on. You want to just issue some SQL queries or some Mongo queries directly against the data to see what the data looks like. And there is a data viewer on, you know, on the dashboard, but it's not that great. It's you know, and it only works with certain kinds of data types, and you can't really update anything. So if you really just need to flip some field, you know, the status of something, and just that way you can keep processing, and then you can work on fixing your bug and getting it out, you know, later that day or tomorrow or whatever. You can't do that, and which is frustrating. But you know, on the other hand, it might force you to build some more infrastructure, you know, administrative kind of features that. If you can fix things easily with some duct tape, you end up kind of not really building a good administrative interface. So sometimes when the only way you can do it is by building an administrative interface.
Okay, yeah, so some of those limitations seem to, you know, not be without reason, but, you know, they are limitations.
Yeah.
It was funny when we were talking before this, some of the Udacity guys had mentioned that, you know, if they were designing a website or they're building a website that needed to scale to many, many users, App Engine would be, you know, a great choice. And I kind of mentioned, you know, well, if I was building a toy website, App Engine would be my first go-to, so I don't have to deal with any of that, you know, crud of data installing databases and Memcache and mm-hmm. app servers and frameworks and
setting up
stuff.
A deploy process, all that.
Oh yeah, deployment. Yeah. Man, we spend. That's something we haven't touched on in this or in any of my units. Is when you start having multiple machines, deploying code across multiple machines is something that you have to think about, and there's different strategies. Mm-hmm. And the versioning is mm-hmm. stuff is cool in App Engine. So. I want to thank you for doing this with us. This is really cool. I've learned a lot from talking to you guys about how App Engine works, and I hope the students have got some better perspective on whether App Engine is the right choice for them.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me, and thank you for your class. We've had really great feedback, and
cool.
It's been fun
cool.
having this sort of class.
Cool. Glad to hear it. And so that wraps it up for Unit 7, which wraps it up for the whole course. So. Wow. You know, thank you everybody for participating this far. If you made it this far, you are a champion of web applications. And you know, the only thing left for you is the final, which we'll get to next.